Okay, hi, it's Dave here. Today I'm going to show you how to fix this a KDS monitor. And this particular one is a KDS K917s. That's the product number. And the model number is a 900P. Made in October 2005. Okay, so the first thing you want to do is these two tabs here get pushed in and the bottom base comes off. Next, right along the front edge are a bunch of little screws here. What you want to do is remove them. What you do now is you slide the bezel forward like that, and then it comes on. And there's six screws around the edge here that have to be removed, so the back comes off. Careful not to hit the screen. It doesn't hurt to give the screen a clean while you got it apart at this particular moment in time. Okay, so now you'll see down inside here, there's a number of connectors that have to be unplugged to take the LCD display off. There's a couple here that go to a lamp here and here. Okay, and then this one here, which is the interface plug. So you just grasp it firmly, pull straight out. Like so. Over here, to take out the lamp ones, I'm going to lay it down. Just tilt it up like this. Okay, there's the back piece off. And you move the display out of the way where it won't get damaged. Okay, so power supply is located inside here. Now you want to remove the seven screws holding this cover on. Okay, to remove this cover, we just lift straight up and tuck these little wires through. Okay, and there's the board right here. Okay, so next you want to remove the four screws here, here, and here. Okay. That secure the board into the case. Be careful not to damage any of the surface mounted components. Now the problem with this monitor was that it would run for about half an hour and then it wouldn't work for a while after that. So it would work for about a half an hour. If you turned it off and rebooted your computer or anything like that, then the monitor wouldn't work. It would be blank. Okay, we got to take the ground screw off here. And you pull this little plug out of its slot here. Okay? And these are the components here that you want to change. All these in here. This. Okay? Okay, so what we want to do is desolder these capacitors. So I start with the first one here. I want to remove these capacitors, so you got to desolder them first. So I've got a desoldering tool and my soldering iron. I'm just going to remove the solder from the holes carefully. Lots of surface mounted components on the back of this. Okay. So here's the new capacitors. You want to make sure you get the polarity lined up here. So the black is negative. So start here. Put that one in. Bend the leads over a little bit. Put in the next one. Always observing the polarity. Bend that one a little bit. One here. Polarity. Okay, put that one in. That's the oddball one. Check the polarity on this one. Okay, so now I'm going to solder all these leads and then I'll clip off the long extra lengths. Now what I'm going to do now is use my little cutters and clip the leads off, set the leads down, because you don't want them flying into some other thing that you have sitting around the room, which I have lots of things. So there you have it. We replaced all these capacitors here. There's six of them. Let's check the polarity on them one more time. They all look like they're in straight. So reinstalling the board is the same thing in reverse. What you have to do though is you have to make sure that this little connector here lines up with this properly and you don't bend any of the pins. So now what you do is you line up the cover and slide these connectors through. Okay, so we lay the display down to one side like this, and then we match these connectors back up again and plug them in. I marked them with markers so that they would go back the exact same way they came out. Okay. Lift the monitor up, flip it over a bit. Okay, and then reach in here with your hand, like so, and plug this connector back in carefully. There, you should hear it click into place. And put the screen back down like that, and put in the six screws that hold the screen into the case. Now to reinstall the bezel, it goes on like this. And then you slide it downward, like so. There. Put the four screws back in again. And bingo, you're done.